Indonesia has around 210 million people, most of them living the same as they have for the last 100 years. They're spread across 13,000 islands scattered in a tropical archipelago below the Asian mainland. And we're starting our adventure in Bali.
Let's go get amongst these snakes and surf. Yeah, picked up a little bit of the lingo, and what we're going to do is try and go flat out like a lizard drinking straight through Bali. We're going to duck and weave easily. The most dangerous part of this journey is the Balinese roads, mate. Right on, where are you?
Yeah, for the ferry.
As we leave the city, the scene changes into a continuous landscape of villages and cultivated land. The main crop is rice, and it's known locally as nasi, and the paddy fields are perfect habitats for a whole range of reptiles. Wherever there's grain, you'll find rats, one of the snake's favourite foods, and with this much water, you'll find frogs, also great snake tucker.
Oh, it isn't long before Steve spots a snake in the seedlings.
It's a cobra. Facing me front on, I can't get to him. Crikey, that water's warm. This is the Asian spittle. Ah! Lucky I got these glasses on. He's spitting all over me. Also known as the equatorial cobra. Settle down, mate. Settle down now. And this is a big specimen. Crikey, this is a beauty. And what he's been doing is hunting in the nice warm water. They'll eat anything they come across. They'll come out of these corridors, into the nasi, into the rice, pick up any rodents, any frogs this time of year. You're an angry cobra. And look at the... Oh. Look at the way he's hooding up. They've got about a 6-foot strike range with their venom, and you... It's like acid. It's got a strong taste to it. It's got a real strong taste. He just keeps spitting. Notice how he's more inclined to spit than bite. Ooh, there's another predator thing there, trying to scare me away. Isn't he a beauty? They're egg layers. They usually have anywhere from 6 to 20 odd eggs, and they're one of the few big animals, few big reptiles that I'm likely to encounter close to the rice. Woo-hoo, yes, how would you be? I'm shaking. Look at this, I'm shaking like a leaf. I don't know whether that's venom or sweat. It's just starting to flow down my face. My eyes aren't burning. I've got a fair whack in my mouth. But have a go at that. That's venom on the outside and sweat on the inside.
Steve's got to get the venom off before it gets into his eyes.
Oh, that's better.
By the look of that water, it's not much better than the venom.
It's the monsoon season. One minute, it's steamy and sunny. The next, it's a torrential downpour. And I'm making my way through the jungle to a temple where there's a population of sacred monkeys. The old religion here believes that every animal, every plant, even water and rocks are inhabited by their own distinctive spirits. The Balinese see God's spirits and demons all around them, and in this place, the playful monkey reigns supreme. At first, they just watch me, checking me out, deciding if I'm dangerous, perhaps a playmate, maybe a source of food.
Look, see this big male come in? These are all babies, these are all youngsters. And this male's just come in and sorted them out. They've got a pretty wild social structure. Big, dominant males rule.
And these blokes are commonly known as macaques. They're temple monkeys and revered for their playfulness and intelligence. The Balinese associate them with magic and a keen understanding of human behaviour. You can see why.
You've got a great haircut. Have a go at their fingers and their hands. Exactly the same as mine. And their feet, check out her feet. She's got an opposable toe, just like mine. Their hands are very similar to their feet. Are you going to jump on me? You're jumping on me. Are you looking for something? You're going to groom my hair. There's nothing in there. You can look. Ooh, big male. When they do the thing, that means we're upset and back off.
The advice you get in Indonesia is that the monkeys can be unpredictable and don't try and touch them, because a bite is nasty.
Here, fight, fight, fight. Ooh, you can see the way that big male rules. Watch his teeth. Look at this. Did you see them? Oh, mate, I'd hate to get bitten by one of them.
The monkeys form tight little friendship units inside the bigger troop. And just look at what great mums they are. Those babies, they stay right under their mother's nose. And when they're this tiny little babies, they hardly get to stray more than a few inches from mum. And how's this for a protective mother? She's determined to keep her baby safe. It's just as well the monkeys have such strong family bonds. There's a lot of danger in the jungle, especially when you're tiny and vulnerable. And here's something that wouldn't need a baby monkey, but packs a heck of a punch.
Cobra.
It's another spitter, and Steve needs glasses to protect his eyes.
He's grumpy too. You're all right, mate, you're all right. Oh, no. Haven't brought me glasses. Listen, the monkey's starting to get upset. You're gonna bite me, aren't you? He's not even hooding up, this one. Hey, you're not even hooding up. What a beautiful snake. They're relatively common throughout these temples, particularly the ones that are way out in the jungle where there's no people. Very unlike the other cobras I've come across, which have just hooded up straight away. Big snake, you can see he's in really healthy condition. Probably eating rats and mice, I'd reckon. You mean eating rats and mice, mate? Oh, he's starting to hood up now. Hey, he's starting to hood up a bit now, aren't you? Ooh, there's his little hood starting to come out. He's getting really agitated now. The monkeys will actually have a go at him. Monkeys are quick enough and smart enough to get the snakes and harass them. So what they do is just wait until nighttime before they start coming out. What a beautiful animal. You've been eating lots of rats around this temple, haven't you? Hey, you've been eating lots of rats. Do you want to go back hunting? Hey, you want to go do some hunting? You're a good snake.